welcome to another Monday of Replay Mondays. Ooh, I'm so excited about this. It's going to be a series of words from the Father over the next. Do y'all not know what God is doing for us? Even in rest, He's rebuilding us. The word that He's going back to get to replay is just what we need in this season. And when I tell y'all I'm excited. I'm so excited because God has not left us without answers. God has not left us without strength. God has not left us without peace. This Monday, oh my God, this series that we're about to embark on how not to give up in prayer. Because prayer is your weapon, baby. Prayer is your weapon, baby. My God, on how not to give up in prayer, because prayer is your weapon. And you're getting ready to get infused with a supernatural strength that's going to dismantle every plot and plan of the enemy. My God, why? Because your prayer, your praise, your prayer life about to change. Your praise about to change. You're going to start pulling down strongholds just with the word of God. In Jesus' name, amen. So stay tuned to how to not give up in prayer. How to not give up in prayer. And we will be right back so that we can do our confessions. Oh my God, I love you. Father God, I thank you for your power that's about to be on this word that's going to transform our lives. Open the eyes of our understanding to the hope of who you called us to be in Christ Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Woo!
Good morning. This is Lakeisha Johnson. Doing a little video blog, and I typically write everything, but wanted to share a few things this morning. I guess we're going to start calling these coffee and conversation as I get acclimated to doing these things for the Lord. This morning, I wanted to share, or what the Lord put on my heart to share was don't give up in prayer for your children. Seems like at this season or time, kids are just really, really struggling. We've had peer pressure, but it seems like they have peer pressure or things around them and more access to things than we've had. They're struggling with things that we didn't necessarily struggle with or that no one necessarily talked to us about. And so I just want to share a few quick things with you. And these were the things that the Lord just had me put on my heart to share about our kids, and how important prayer is, like how essential prayer is. If you don't know, I have 5 sons. My oldest son is 24, 22, 20, 12, and 7. And what I've seen happen, or what I know is a necessity or has been for us in prayer, and especially since my life partner is now gone and it's just me in the house, my prayer life, or the capacity of my prayer life, has changed intensely. I find myself a lot of times on my face before God, asking Him for clear guidance and direction. Jermaine was the wisdom in our house, and one of the things that I've believed God for is to be wise. I've asked Him to give me the same wisdom that Jermaine had for our sons, because when he left, that's the first thing everybody said, is we really miss Dad's wisdom. And so this morning, I'm always drinking coffee. I wanted to share something with you. I'm going to read this, and this is out of the ESV version, and it's 1 Thessalonians 5:16 and 18, and it says, "Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, giving thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you." And I know when our kids are just bad as heck, we don't want to spend a whole lot of time in prayer. We don't want to spend a whole lot of time. We really want to choke that joker out. I have been there. I have wanted to probably kick somebody out and not say anything, absolutely anything else to them. But with the love and compassion that we have in our heart as parents, it's important that we pray, without ceasing, that we pray at a level and a capacity and intensity for them. I am the direct result of prayer. My teenage years were troublesome. I know my mom probably wanted to choke me out, but because of her and my grandmother, they never gave up in me in prayer. The second part of that is praying with supplication. When we go to Philippians 4:6, it tells us to pray with supplication. Prayer and supplication is what the King James Version says. And I was looking up supplication. Supplication is a form of prayer when one party asked another party to provide something. So in supplication, asking the Lord whatever it is your kids need. The last 12 days I've been praying specifically for one of my sons, and I've been writing down everything that I need to see the Lord do in his life, not sparing anything, talking about him being a man of character and a man of God and being able to provide and preparing his wife for him, which are things I've prayed for my kids since they were little. But talking about integrity and talking about his work ethic, like, I've committed these 12 days to pray for him. And so praying without supplication, asking God. And sometimes people tell me our prayer doesn't seem like it's working, and I get that, but Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all my heart, lean not into my own understanding. What we don't understand in this physical world, the Lord is definitely seeing in the spiritual world. He sees things that we don't see. And if we just take the opportunity and chance not to give up in prayer, then we'll begin to see a work of God. I'm telling you, since Jermaine has left, my boys have struggled. We've had struggles that we have not necessarily talked about, but things that we've seen go on in this house. And the Lord just kept reminding me, because for a minute I thought sometimes my sons were the enemy. And the Lord just kept telling me, the enemy, we wrestle not against flesh and blood. They are just the weapons, or it seems like this is the attack, but it's not. You got to persist in prayer. You got to put yourself in a position to pray. You got to trust and believe that I'm working on their behalf, even when that doesn't look like it. Even when you're in a position or a circumstance in a situation and it looks like everything is failing, persist in prayer. Pray out loud. Let them know that you're praying for them. So definitely we're praying. You know, we're rejoicing always too. We're doing this in supplication. Put that request before God. It's, if you want to see your kid succeed in college, I pray over their grades. My sons have to confess that they will honor and respect those in authority. I pray that they learn how to submit to authority. Like, those are the things that I pray over my kid. And then of course, trusting God. You don't need to trust them. You need to trust God. Kids are going to be kids. My kids have done some things that I know I'm looking at that joker with one eye, but I trust God to be God in their life. God gave me something in scripture when I was really worried over my son. In Isaiah 54:13, it says, all your children will be taught of the Lord, and great will be their peace. And righteousness will be established. So if I'm teaching them and I'm giving them what they need, then hey, they're going to be steadfast in that. Even when I look like, it's a train up a child in the way they should go, and they will return. I'm a return. I'm telling you, I'm a return. Anybody that knows my story is, I'm a return. I am a direct result of the return. The training was there and I returned. And so I have to also allow that grace for my kids. My other example, or my last thing to you, is be the example for them. Kids these days are real. And if you're not being real with them, they're not hearing this. This is not a do as you say generation. Do as I say, and then I go live my life any kind of way. And that's what Ephesians, when it says Ephesians, fathers, do not exasperate your children. Don't push them to the edge. Don't get in a position and you're not living that life before them. You can't ask your kids to do something that you're not living. A lot of times I always ask myself, am I providing an example for them that I want them to walk out? Am I telling them on the telephone, if somebody call about business, I'm not here? That's teaching little white lies. Well, if I don't want them to lie to me, then I can't teach them to lie to other people. for me being single now, am I modeling before them what a godly woman should look like, a single godly woman? And I make mistakes and I slip and I fall all the time. But what I've learned is if I come back and recenter myself and put myself back into the position of prayer and ask the Lord even to show me the areas of my life that don't look like him so that I can be a better example for them. But whatever you do, don't give up prayer. So that's my, I guess, coffee and conversation with you this morning. Don't give up on your kids in prayer. I don't care how faithless it looks. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care if it looks like it don't work. Keep praying. Keep pushing. Keep thinking. Keep thinking positive. Give them good seed. Kids most of the time already know when they're doing stuff they don't have any business. Keep giving them. You don't even know some of the stuff your kids may be struggling with at school. The things that they feel insecure about. Sometimes we think our kids talking to us about stuff and they're at school being bullied and we don't even know that they're at school being bullied or they're struggling with things. I have friends that are teachers that have told me the cruelness of kids. Kids' parents don't even know some of the sexual things that kids are doing, especially on social media and Instagram. And check that social media, because you could be praying for something and the enemy is working against you and their peers are telling them that this is acceptable. And when you find something out is going on with your child, identify it. Don't ignore it. Don't play like it. Find you a support system and a set of intercessors that will get in prayer for you and with you. But whatever you do, don't give up in prayer. I'm going to pray right now. We're going to get out of here. I got to wake up these Johnson boys so that we can get and go to church. Go find my page. I'm taking some of this stuff off my personal page and going to this page, Lakeisha M. Johnson, just feeling this push from the Lord. Let me pray for everybody. Love you guys. Keep me lifted in prayer. Father, we thank you for this day, for all you are, for who you are, for who you are to our children, Lord God. I ask that you strengthen every parent, Father God, that hears this message, Lord God, to not give up on their children in prayer. Lord, you told us to pray without ceasing, Lord God, believing you for a return on every seed that we've invested in them. Bless our children, Lord God. Let the Christ be formed in each and every one of them, and the kingdom of heaven their priority. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father God, for their purpose and for what you called them to do, and for you giving us them, because they're not ours, they're yours. And we thank you for this opportunity before you. We love you, Lord, and thank you, and we bless you. Thank you guys for tuning in and for listening to this. Again, go like my page, Lakeisha M. Johnson. Go get. If you need a prayer partner, find you some prayer partners. Praying, we praying over these kids. We're not giving up on our kids. We're praying. Even though we're seeing all this violence, we're going to become steadfast and pray over our kids. It's essential. This week I'll be talking to you more about prayer. Today was about our kids. Tomorrow we'll be talking about prayer and our spouses and our life mate. Even though I don't have a life mate, I promise you, I know what it was like to walk out marriage for 13 years and how hard sometimes marriage can be and how essential prayer is to your marriage. So tune in tomorrow morning, and I'm early in the morning. Some of y'all won't be up, but you can see the video. Love you guys. Later. Peace and blessing.
Ooh! Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for strengthening our prayer life and helping us to overcome every plot and plan of the enemy through prayer. Prayer is going to be your weapon in this season. You're not going to even speak, my God, on negative things. You're going to let a prayer and a praise roll out your mouth before you do anything else. Why? This is the kind of God we serve. Woo! My God, thank you for your word today. Thank you for equipping us in your word today. Two things. If the Lord places it on your heart to give to this ministry, go to the website, LakeishaMJohnson.com, and give there. Ooh, or Cash App us, $LMJ Ministry. Next, if you have not received Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior in your life, I need you to do me a favor. I need you to repeat after me. This needs to be the deciding moment. Dear Jesus, ooh, I'm in need of a Savior. I'm asking you to come into my heart and to take away my sins, and I promise to love and follow you best I can. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. If you just prayed that prayer, send us an email info@justbeinglmj.com, and we're going to send you some resources and some materials. Now let's get ready to confess. Oh, I got a couple announcements. One, Chase That Lion, we're not going to be every other week. We'll be back this Friday at 12 noon. If you're not a part of the group has changed. It's no longer Coffee and Conversations Daily Devotionals. That group is called the Dream Academy by LMJ Ministries. And I want you to experience what God is about to do in this group so that we can unlock your dreams and you can go beyond anything you ever imagined to live bold with God. And we'll share the link for that as well. Oh, I'm so excited. Ladies, don't forget Tuesday night, Ladies Bible House Bible Study. We are studying the storehouse principle. And I cannot wait till God shows us how to be higher in our levels of financial steward so we can support the kingdom together. Oh, we're about to be some bad chicks for the Lord. We're about to be some bad chicks for the Lord. So make sure you're divinely connected to those groups. Let's get our confessions in. I'm so ready to confess the word of God because I know every time I confess or pray the word of God, it's dismantling every plan of the enemy. My God, and we confess the word of God because it reminds us of God's love and power. And if you didn't share the devotional, go ahead and get the devotional shared. Let somebody else be able to tap into this so that their prayer can change. Praise is a weapon, but our prayer life disarms every plan and plot of the enemy, and we want to be right there in that zone. Oh my God, I'm a new creature in Christ. All things have passed away. Behold, all things are new. 2 Corinthians 5:17. I've died and been raised with Christ and now seated in heavenly places. Ephesians 2:5-6. I am dead to sin and alive unto righteousness. Romans 6:11. No weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. For at every tongue that rises against me in judgment, I shall show to be in the wrong. Isaiah 54:17. I prosper in everything I put my hands to. I have prosperity in all areas of my life, spiritually, financially, mentally, and socially. I take every thought captive unto the obedience of Jesus Christ, casting down every imagination and every high and lofty thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. Therefore, all my thoughts are positive. I do not allow Satan to use my spirit as a garbage dump by meditating on negative things that he offers me. I don't speak negative things. I am purpose that my mouth shall not transgress. I will speak forth the righteousness of God all day long. I never bind a sister or brother with the words of my mouth. I'm always a positive encouragement. I edify and build up. I never tear down and destroy. I'm a believer, not a doubter. I'm slow to speak, quick to hear, and slow to anger. I'm a doer of the word. I meditate on his word all day long. I will study the word of God. I will pray. I never get tired or grow weary when I study the word, pray, minister, or praise God. But I'm alert and full of energy. And as I study, I become more alert and more energized. I'm a giver. It is more blessed to give than to receive. I pray that you become such a liberal giver, ooh, that as soon as you release seed out, it'll be coming back into your hand. I love to give. I have plenty of money to give away all the time. I cast all my care on the Lord, for he cares for me. I don't have a spirit of fear, but a power of love and a sound mind. I do not fear, and I am not guilty. Come on, y'all. I'm not passive about anything in my life. I deal with all things in my life immediately. I do not judge my brothers and sisters in Christ Jesus after the flesh. I'm a spiritual man. And I'm judged by no one. I operate in all the gifts of the Holy Spirit, which are tongues and interpretation of tongues, the working of miracles, discerning of spirit, the word of faith, the word of knowledge, the word of wisdom, healing, and prophecy. I walk in the spirit all of the time. I've been set free. I'm free to love, to worship, to trust, with no fear of rejection or being hurt. I have compassion and understanding for all people. I do not hate or walk in unforgiveness. I catch the enemy and all his lies, deceitful lies. And I cast them down and choose whether to believe the word of God. Work is good. I enjoy work. I do all my work excellently and with great prudence, making the most of all my time. I'm a responsible person. I enjoy responsibility and I rise to every responsibility in Jesus. I'm creative because the Holy Spirit lives in me. I take good care of my body. I eat right. I look good. I feel good. And I weigh exactly what God wants me to weigh. Pain cannot successfully come against my body because Jesus bore all my pain. I lay hands on the sick and they recover. I have a teachable spirit. I do not think more highly of myself than I ought to in the flesh. I've humbled myself and God has exalted me. I do what I say I will do and I get where I'm going on time. I don't hurry and rush. I do one thing at a time. I'm anointed of God for ministry. I'm an obedient wife. Ooh, thank you, Lord God, that in my singleness, my God, you've given me the desires. Ooh, my God, that I desire you first. But because I desire you first, you've given me the desires of my heart. So I thank you, Lord God, my God, that you are causing me and my husband to meet. In Jesus' name, amen. My husband is wise. He is the king and priest of our home. He makes godly decisions. All my children have lots of Christian friends, and God has set aside a Christian wife or husband for each of them. My children love to pray and study the word. They openly and boldly praise God. My children make right choices according to the word of God. All my household are blessed in their deeds. We're blessed when we come in and when we go out, and all that we own is paid for, and we own no one anything except to love them. Oh, Lord, thank you for your word today. Thank you for your word today. Look, I'll see y'all in the morning. As Judah J says, live at 5. Live at 5. I will see y'all in the morning. Live at 5. I love y'all. God loves you. I love you. God loves you. My God. My God. Go be loved today. Love, peace, and blessing.
Okay, classic. Okay, classic.
Oh, ain't nobody stopping my shine.